Welcome to episode 839, Yusaku Maezawa, 10 Lessons. This is an outline of episode 839, lesson 1 to lesson 5. This is lesson 6 to lesson 10. Lesson 1, I always do what I love.
I loved music, so I decided to start a band and quit high school. I was very excited about the idea of developing this band. I always do what I love.
Lesson 2, no education. He quit high school.
As an adolescent, you also decided not to go to college. Why not?
I didn't want to become a salaryman like normal people.
Lesson 3, he made billions in e-commerce. Actually, many of the richest billionaires in the world also made it in e-commerce. His e-commerce site is called SoSoTown.
And you started collecting CDs. That's actually what started your business at first.
That's true. I started collecting CDs and old records. I moved to the US and I stayed there for only 6 months. But during that time, I bought so many records, so I decided to start selling them online. And that website later became my first business.
Lesson 4, his original goal was not to be rich.
Was it always an ambition for you to become rich?
No, I never even imagined I would become rich. I just did what I did and I got rich as a result. I'm not attached to wealth, really. I still don't know how much money I have.
Lesson 5. Maezawa, the inventor. His invention is the Zozo suit.
そのボディースーツにたくさんのこのドットがついてるんですけど、それをスマホのカメラで読んでメジャーメントするっていう技術を採用しました。まあ全部自分たちで自社開発で作ったんですけど。
Lesson 6, 6-hour workday for his employees. I think this is a world record.
He, interesting sort of philosophy about work. He imposed a 6-hour workday at his company to give employees more family time.
Lesson 7, womanize.
He actually has 3 kids with 2 different women. He's never married, but he's famous for kind of...
He would become a famous womanizer. And these are the pictures of some of his girlfriends. Lesson 8, Maezawa will be the first billionaire on the moon in 2023.
First of all, what does it mean to you to be the first civilian to go to the moon? Is it a kid's dream come true?
I always liked adventure since I was a child, but I never dreamt that I'd fly to the moon until recently. About 5 years ago, I heard that it would be possible for ordinary people to travel to the moon, and that made me want to go there. It's the most romantic, challenging, and fun adventure that I can undertake today. That's the reason why I want to go there.
Lesson 9, do not be afraid to take up challenges.
What's the key to success for young entrepreneurs who are watching us? What's your advice for them?
I hope they pursue what they love doing, like myself, and they should never be afraid to take on challenges.
Lesson 10, world peace is his real mission.
Part of a project called Dear Moon, it's almost like a letter you're writing to the moon. Why artists and not scientists?
Many of the people who have been to space so far are scientists or astronauts. I don't think there have been any artists. I'm looking forward to seeing what kind of impact space travel will have on artists' work. My dream is not so much to go to space, but to pursue world peace.
Yes, this is his mission.
My idea was that by taking artists along with me, we would be able to bring a message of peace more easily and spread it around the world in a better way.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.